life on the farm was very different from the way it is today. And kids on farms were very different from what they are today. We got up every morning because my father thought if you slept past 6 o'clock, you know, you would die in bed. So we got up every morning and we went out and we pulled weeds out of beans. And I have said that if anyone really looked back at our family and wanted to know what drove us all to go to school for so long and so often, they only had to look at the bean fields, because we learned early that we didn't want to toil in the heat and the sun all day. And my father didn't want us to either. He really didn't want any of us to stay on the farm. And he preached education from the time we were just little. I can remember that he was the one that went with all of us for our high school education. And I did not type. When I came to Lakeland College, it was really hard for me because I didn't know how to type. I couldn't enter all the things I needed to as division chairman because I didn't type, and I had to take a keyboarding class. And I can still remember my father going into the guidance counselor when I was in the eighth grade and saying, "This girl is not taking typing. She is not going to be a secretary. She is going to go on to school, to college, and get an education. That's what she's going to do." And we did. All of us did. There was 2 years age difference between us. We were always close. We were always tight. I hear people talk about families and, you know, that they're not close to their sister, and I just can't fathom it, because she and I could look at her across a room. Somebody could say something and I could look at her across the room, take one look at her eyes, and she'd go like this. And I knew exactly what she was thinking. I mean, we would get out and she would say, "Do you believe?" Or we just always, we had the same background. We had the same memories. We had the same parents who pushed us. And then we had similar goals to help other people. You know, to make a living, of course, first. I mean, you know, that was important. You needed to be able to take care of yourself. But once your basic goals are met, and you have enough for yourself, then it became imperative to do something for other people. And we would talk about that together. Each of us had a scholarship. She had a scholarship. Of course, sometimes people didn't know they were our scholarships, because we had the Robert Leonard Fuquay Scholarship and the Mildred Harlan Fuquay Scholarship. And I had Mom and she had Dad. And we would fund that scholarship every year. And then I retired and she and I started talking, and she said, "Well," she says, "you know, I'm just kind of thinking." She says, "You know, you're okay. And I am okay." She says, "So what would you think if we did a foundation with some of this money?" And I said, "Not a problem, you know, not a problem." So she left $1.5 million, of which Lakeland is receiving the interest paid every year from a third of that. The Salvation Army is getting a third of that, and Catholic Charities is getting a third of that. There's a foundation board. My daughter and my son-in-law are on the board. We're the family members who are on the board. And then the heads of the foundations of the three charities. It cannot be spent on buildings. It cannot be spent on operating expenses. It can be spent on people, on students at Lakeland College, on services that Catholic Charities has to for their prescription program. But it can't build buildings. It can't do capital things. It can't operate anything, because she wanted to go to people who needed help. People should know what a kind heart she had, how kind and loving she was, that she really, really wanted the best for people. She wanted the best out of them and for them. She was a wonderful, wonderful woman. And I'm prejudiced. I know I am. But I can't think of anyone better than my sis. You cannot put a price on what Lakeland College has done for more young men and young women than people will ever know. It has changed lives. It has made people able to take care of their families. It has given them independence. It has given them careers. It has changed more lives, really, than anything else in this town, I believe. Education does change lives. Lakeland College is an incalculable asset. It just makes more difference than anybody would ever know. It is a wonderful, wonderful place, and it was a wonderful place to work. It's the best job I ever had.